Welcome to the Myeloma University module entitled Treatment of Multiple Myeloma with Monoclonal Antibodies. My name is Donna Catamero, and I am a nurse practitioner with the Mount Sinai Health System in New York City. In this short discussion, we will learn about monoclonal antibodies that treat myeloma by helping the immune system recognize and destroy myeloma cells. Myeloma cells are flagged when the monoclonal antibody binds to the antigens, which are specific proteins found on the myeloma cells. Nurses should know that monoclonal antibodies given in combination therapies are very efficacious. However, these therapies may cause administration-related reactions, which may be respiratory in nature, as well as causing fever, chills, and rigors. Now let's begin. Recent approvals of monoclonal antibodies have revolutionized the treatment of multiple myeloma. Monoclonal antibodies are a type of immunotherapy that afford a targeted approach to treatment directed primarily against the myeloma cells. Monoclonal antibodies can restore, enhance, or mimic the immune system's attack on myeloma cells. They are designed to bind to antigens on the surface of myeloma cells and are involved in several key mechanisms to cause cell death. First, the monoclonal antibodies flag the myeloma cells. Then the patient's own immune system can identify and attack the myeloma cells. And finally, monoclonal antibodies can directly cause or induce apoptosis or cell death. There are several monoclonal antibodies approved for multiple myeloma. When combined with a proteasome inhibitor or modulatory agent, we see improved patient outcomes. Here are some examples of monoclonal antibodies used to treat multiple myeloma. Daratumumab targets the CD38 antigen, which is primarily found on myeloma cells. Daratumumab can be administered as either an IV infusion or a subcutaneous injection and is approved in several combination therapies both in the frontline as well as the relapse refractory setting. Isatuximab is another monoclonal antibody that targets the CD38 and is administered as an IV infusion or in combination with pomalidomide or carfilzomib in the relapse setting. Please note that while CD38 is primarily found on myeloma cells, it's also found on red blood cells. And I will circle back as to why that's important to remember when administering a monoclonal antibody that targets CD38. Elotuzumab activates the natural killer cells through the SLAMF7 pathway. The SLAMF7 of the myeloma cells are targeted and flagged for natural killer cell-mediated cell death. Elotuzumab is an IV infusion given in combination with either lenalidomide or pomalidomide in the relapsed or refractory setting. There are several key considerations when administering monoclonal antibodies. There is a risk of administration-related reactions. Therefore, it's important to pre-medicate patients with acetaminophen, an antihistamine, and a corticosteroid. With administration of monoclonal antibodies, we infuse at a slower rate for the first infusion. With subcutaneous administration, we will monitor the patient in the clinic post-dosing. Please refer to the prescribing information for further dosing and administration instructions. Administration reactions are typically respiratory in nature, which can present as bronchospasms, dyspnea, nasal congestion, and coughing. Therefore, it's important to educate our patients on what symptoms to expect and when to alert their healthcare team. When administering daratumumab or isatuximab, we need to perform a type and screen prior to the first dose. While CD38 is primarily found on myeloma cells, it's also found on red blood cells. After the first administration of drug, it will appear as if the patient has antibodies to their red blood cells. However, this is just a drug interference and transfusions can safely be given. It is important that we give patients an identification card to alert other providers of this interference. Additionally, there can be interference with response assessment. There is a co-migration of therapeutic antibody with the myeloma protein or M-spike during laboratory testing. This can cause us to overestimate the amount of myeloma protein and thus underestimate the patient's response to treatment. Foremost, it's important that we are aware of this issue. Additionally, there are laboratory assays available, such as high-resolution mass spectrometry, that can be utilized to minimize the effects of this interference. Monoclonal antibodies have significantly changed how we manage patients. In combinations with other novel agents, we see improved patient outcomes with monoclonal antibodies. They are effective and well tolerated, demonstrating deep and durable responses. As nurses, we play a key role in assessment and management of administration-related toxicities. Thank you for joining me today to share in this discussion of treatment of multiple myeloma with monoclonal antibodies. And please watch for additional segments in this series.